All right, plate prep time. So before we put any ground on our plates, we have to clean it, we have to polish it. And first thing first, we'll be inspecting our plates. So always look at your plate or your work from different angles, because just looking at the surface or staring at it with one angle, it's not gonna give you the right impression. So I usually check the scratches with my nail. So we have some minor scratches here. So if your nail catches the scratch, that means you have to work on those areas. Another way to inspect is to be sure if those scratches are superficial or not. So yeah, there are a couple of minor scratches on the left side and a couple of in the middle. So the some of the materials you will be using to prepare your plate are, well, there are a couple of options. You can use sandpapers, you can start with maybe 320 and you can finish it with 400, but I prefer using steel wool. And you can start with coarse, number 2, number 3. Usually I prefer number 2, number 3 can be too coarse, and finish it with 4 zeros. So this is the fine, start with the coarse and finish cleaning or sanding down your plate with fine, either sandpaper or steel wool. And other materials, other tools, of course, you will have to bevel the edges, as always, and burnisher, and if only you have deep scratches, you can gently scrape those areas, just the surface, gently on top of the lines, scratches. Then you can go over with burnisher. But we will not be using our burnishers or scraper directly on the plate, so you need some buffer. And you can use vegetable oil, WD-40, you can use plate oil. So you need some buffer before you start working on those scratches. And other, this is engraver's charcoal, and it's very, 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 very useful. So this can, as well as it functions like burnisher, but even more useful, you can use engraver's charcoal with water, but WD-40, it has good viscosity, so WD-40 could be okay. So first WD-40 on the scratches and work on with engraver's charcoal. So I will first use a piece of steel wool. Use it directly first. course, you may ask why I shouldn't use power tool like a sander, electric sander or orbital sander. But one aspect of Intaglio, or to me, overall printmaking, crafts and handcraft, every handcraft, every process you use, you create with your hands, it will give you another skill. So Brasso, you may consider doing this step outside or in a well-ventilated area. So just shake it just a few seconds to mix it well. And you don't need much, And this basically makes it polishes your plate. Don't need much. You spread it, even this is enough. Let it set for a few seconds. Let's say 1 minute. Let's clean the edges, and the last step, unless your plate comes with back cover, you have to spray paint the back of your plate. This is the back, this is the front. So you will have to spray paint the back of your plate. And for that, we will be using our spray boot. So warming up our plate will prevent bubbling. When we apply the hard ground, liquid hard ground, your ground may have some air bubbles. So slightly warming up our plate will prevent those bubbles. So this is our hot plate, and I will set 400. And whenever we use the hot plate, we must turn on our ventilation. So now the ventilation is on. So I'm warming up the hot plate now, and after it is warm, I will put our perfectly degreased copper plate and warm it up 5 minutes max. It will be fine, and after that we will apply the hard ground, liquid hard ground. Now it is time to apply our liquid hard ground. So this is where we keep our liquid hard ground. Liquid hard ground, basically it is asphaltum, beeswax, and rosin, powdered rosin. So it's always good to stir it, mix it. And as you can see, I have my gloves on, and our ventilation has to be on as well. When you are done using the hard ground, do not forget to cover it, okay? So you have to cover working area as well. Let's get our plate. And after you finish using the hot plate, do not forget to turn it off. You have to turn off our hot plate once you are done. So there are multiple ways to apply hard ground, liquid hard ground on a plate. You can use a brush, you can use a foam brush, you can pour it, but we have a brush and try to be consistent. Just try to be consistent there. Much pressure, just weight of the brush. So I use a few pieces of cardboard or cardstock to elevate the plate, because otherwise most likely, as you can see, it will get stuck on the paper. So carefully that you have to be careful. Let it dry.